up first, and I know it's the one most of you are the most excited about. It is The Stomping Land. This is coming out very soon. They're hoping to hit early access on Steam. The game's been greenlit. It had a very successful Kickstarter. Now, The Stomping Land is basically about running a tribe, hunting, mounting, gathering in a dinosaur-covered tropical world, as you can see from the above video. It's open world. It's basically DayZ with dinosaurs. You can work together with other tribe members to take down big dinosaurs and use them as mounts, or you can fight against each other for domination of the tribes, domination of the areas. There's going to be a number of dinosaurs in the game. This is a Carnotaurus you can see wandering through the forest right now. In a second, I'm about to swap to a new video. There you go, that's a Puertasaurus, a huge sauropod, to really give you a good sense of the scale and awesomeness that this game is going to provide. As with all the other games, there will be a link to the website or Facebook of this game. Go check it out, it's going to be incredible. Most hyped dinosaur game for a long time. The next game up is Prehistoric Kingdom. A lot of controversy surrounding this game, as it used to be part of Jurassic Genetics, and after some fallout with team members purportedly stealing models and such things, the people who felt they were robbed have moved to found Prehistoric Kingdom, and the game is looking fantastic. This is a sort of T-Rex animation preview. You can actually go and do it on their website right now. I'm going to link this as my example for Prehistoric Kingdom. You can click all these buttons and it shows you lots of things. This is about all we've got in terms of video footage, but the game is essentially going to be Jurassic Park Operation Genesis 2. What more could you possibly want in a game? We're all very excited. There we go, T-Rex chomping down a non-existent goat. Now I'm going to go ahead and show you some images and stuff that we've got from the game as well. The guys over there working at Prehistoric Kingdom as well, they're a great group of guys, really seem dedicated to the project. They ask for a lot of fan feedback in terms of Tyrannosaurus Rex colouring and all this kind of stuff, the show content as it comes out, and they've also promised a tech demo within the next few months. Their website and their blog is definitely worth keeping an eye on. We can see things like here, the fences, these are going to form the basis of your park. It's going to be Jurassic Park Operation Genesis 2, and it is going to be awesome. Next up we have Jurassic Park Aftermath. This is the most realistic and best game adaptation of Jurassic Park I've ever seen. This is a one-man development team as far as I know. This guy's running the project on his own. He's hoping to release a walkaround-ish demo in the next few months, and honestly this looks amazing. This is the best recreation of Jurassic Park I've ever seen put to game. It's made in CryEngine, as you can probably tell by how beautiful the graphics are, and it's just basically a one-to-one interpretation of Jurassic Park. We've seen the visitor center, we've seen the jeeps, we've seen the entrance sign there a second ago. You're going to see things like the raptor pen, a really nice shot of the visitor center at night. You can even see that painting at the background where the raptor was during some of the climactic scenes at the end of the film. Like I said, one development guy working on this deserves all the support in the world. Make sure you go check out the Facebook page, tell them how much you're impressed with the work, because this thing, if you can pull it off, is going to be absolutely awesome. Go give it a like, give it a comment, let them know you love it. Number 4 on our list is Project Crinosaurs, one of the only playable games out there now. You can go, you can play a little tech demo of this where you wander around with velociraptors. It's being developed in CryEngine. It's basically a first person open world survival game taking place in Hell Creek. This is a little video that the developers themselves released showcasing some of the dinosaur models, the animations and the sound effects. Really well put together, looks great, and like I said, is actually playable right now. I'm going to link you the tech demo in the description of this video. I've also got my own video on it, you can go and check that out. As you can see, they are definitely aiming for realism. We've got a mottled kind of feathered look to the T-Rex, which may not please everybody, but goddamn it's realistic and we love it. Project Crinosaurs, definitely still being worked on. Updates have been a little scarce, but only been a few months. Very optimistic for this. Can we survive Hell Creek? Let's hope so, eh? Number 5 on our list, and the highest budget of the games by far, is Primal Carnage Genesis. I'm hesitant to even call this one an indie game. This is a single player episodic game coming to the PC and the PlayStation 4. The first of the actual console games in this list so far, and the only console game in this list. A lot of you out there will have obviously played Primal Carnage, which is a multiplayer shooter, dinosaurs versus humans. This is kind of a continuation of that series. A lot of you who have played the game will recognize that T-Rex right there as the Tyrannosaurus Rex from Primal Carnage. Now, the reason most of us are excited about this one is, for one, it is a single-player episodic content. Single-player dinosaur games are always appreciated. But secondly, it's a high-budget game, and the developers clearly have great experience working with dinosaur models and animations and stuff before. The trailers were all very exciting. The information about the game is very exciting, although we don't really have that much yet. We have seen models for several other dinosaurs, like Brachiosaurus and such things, but it's mainly things like you're about to see here that makes us excited for this game. Let's just watch. I'm going to let you guys enjoy the rest of this trailer in case you haven't seen it before, because it's definitely worth watching. Primal Carnage Genesis, definitely one to look out for, meant to be coming out later this year. Not really an indie game like the others are, but definitely worth keeping an eye on. Definitely going to be some very exciting single player dinosaur gaming coming our way soon. Number 6 on our list is the most realistic game in development right now with dinosaurs in it. This is Dinosaur Battlegrounds, another game successfully funded on Kickstarter because people are really excited about the level of realism going into the game. The principle behind it is essentially you will play as and you will raise and you'll grow and become a dinosaur over time. You will have stats to worry about, food to worry about, hunger, other dinosaurs and stuff. You're not playing as a person, there'll be no people. It's essentially surviving in a prehistoric era with dinosaurs, and not just dinosaurs, other prehistoric creatures knocking about. There's images of water-based creatures, we've got pteranodons, all this kind of stuff. The game is being made with the help of several paleontologists and people with a lot of sort of background in dinosaurs and a lot of knowledge about dinosaurs. Everything is hyper realistic, accurate down to a T, as much as, you know, it possibly could be given our relatively limited knowledge of several dinosaurs, but still, it looks fantastic. It's realistic. If you're looking for a simulation dinosaur game, which is a very rare thing that I don't think has ever been done before. Can anyone think of one? Because I'm struggling. I don't think there's ever been a simulation dinosaur game before, not a proper one, and Dinosaur Battlegrounds, despite the name suggesting it might be a different type of game, looks to accurately fill that void. If you are someone who likes your more realistic dinosaur games, less action necessarily, but more really immersing yourself into this prehistoric world and becoming the creatures, then this is definitely a game to keep an eye out for and donate if you can spare the money. Next up is Trespassing. This is a remake of the much maligned but much loved classic Jurassic Park Trespasser, a game I recently played through on the channel. Fantastic game in its own right, but has suffered over time due to clunky initial controls, some poor physics implementation, and a lot of odd design decisions. However, the core of the game, the idea behind the game, is beautiful and could be really good if remade properly, which it definitely looks like this guy is going to manage. He's working pretty much on his own. I believe he has just got some outside help recently. He's recreating a lot of the levels. If you recognize any of them, because you played Jurassic Park Trespasser, that's because he is trying to recreate it pretty much level for level from Trespasser, with ideas to implement his own levels down the line. It looks fantastic. It should be a really good homage to the old game, and I can't wait to play it personally. Now, with the final game in our list of top 8 upcoming dinosaur games, looks familiar to you, it bloody well should do. This is Saurian. Now, Saurian at one point in its development was actually the same game as Dinosaur Battlegrounds. At some point they decided to split off and form two separate projects, but in a collaborative kind of way. They're not fighting with each other, they're not angry at each other, they just decided to split off and go in two different directions. Whereas Dinosaur Battlegrounds is a simulation and intends to cover multiple areas, Saurian is basically meant to be an accurate representation of the ecosystem of the Hell Creek Formation. Now, you'll have heard Hell Creek before. Hell Creek is also the target of Crinosaurs, a very popular region when it comes to dinosaur games. As you can see from the animation work, and again the modelling and texturing, it's going very much for accurate detail, realistic rendering of the dinosaurs. It's not fantasy type stuff, it is meant to be for dinosaur enthusiasts. That's a horrible word to say sometimes. It's for dinosaur enthusiasts and people who know their dinosaurs and want to learn and want to experience what dinosaurs would have actually been like. This is the last game in our list. All 8 of these are currently still in development as of upload of this video on the 12th of April 2014. I'm going to link all 8 to their respective pages and hopefully you guys can go and show your support to the developers, you know. The more support we show these guys, a lot of these are one-man development teams or very small development teams or running with Kickstarter or not even with Kickstarter. The more support we show these guys, the more chance these games have of coming to fruition. And frankly, the more dinosaur games we get out there, the better. Plus, I'll need something to actually bloody play because I'm going to run out eventually, aren't I? Right. I want to thank you all very much for joining me for this video. Please do like, comment, subscribe, and I shall see you lovely people in the next episode for, assumedly, more dinosaur gaming. Until then, cheers, much love. Bye-bye.